thank you for joining us for another episode of the Improve 81 video series. We are here today in Harrisonburg, Virginia, overlooking 81 behind me, to talk about one of our most important projects and one of our more complex projects as well. The project we're discussing today is the widening through Harrisonburg, Virginia. We're widening from 2 lanes to 3 lanes in each direction, both northbound and southbound. One of the things that complicates this project is that we are building new capacity on the interstate right through Harrisonburg, as well as James Madison University. They both lie on the east and west side of Interstate 81. In addition to that, we have several bridges that we have to deal with. Many of them are reaching the end of their useful life, and we need to consider whether we rehabilitate the bridge or replace the bridge entirely. We also have some special structures in this area. Most notably, we have a pedestrian tunnel underneath I-81 connecting the east and west sides of James Madison University. One of the objectives of the project is to minimize our footprint. And for that reason, we are utilizing the existing median space for the new lanes, both northbound and southbound. And now I'd like to introduce you to Scott Alexander, who is the project manager for the I-81 Corridor Improvement Program projects within Stanton District, as well as the project manager for this Harrisonburg Widening project.
Hi, my name is Scott Alexander with Location Design, Stanton District, VDOT. We're here to talk about the widening of I-81 through the city of Harrisonburg, roughly from a mile south of the Route 11 Pleasant Valley Road interchange to about a mile north of the Route 33 interchange. As part of the design efforts, we'll be looking at 8 different structures through the corridor. There's 2 structures over Black's Run, 2 structures over Norfolk Southern Railroad, 2 structures over another crossing of Black's Run, and 2 structures at Country Club Road. We'll be looking at either rehabbing and widening the existing structures or replacing them in full. There are several overpasses that we have to contend with as part of the project. One of them is Pleasant Valley Road, which we will need to replace due to inadequate vertical clearance. One other challenge with the project is the Route 33 bridges, which are currently scheduled to go to construction this summer. So they'll be out of our way, but we will have to contend with potentially overlapping construction schedules. During construction, we do not anticipate daytime closures of the lanes. We will always maintain 2 lanes of traffic. Stormwater management is always a challenge on linear roadway projects, and is especially challenging through Harrisonburg. We have Black's Run crossing the interstate twice through the limits of the project. It is an impaired stream, so we will be taking extra measures to control water quality as it reaches the stream. When the project is complete, residents will notice a large number of stormwater management facilities located along the highway. These are critical to keeping pollutant runoff away from Black's Run. VDOT engineers will begin the analysis for sound walls in the fall of 2021. Once the analysis is complete, we will begin reaching out to residents along the corridor and determine the need or the desire for sound walls in areas of the project. The project will cost about $275 million, and we hope to get under construction at the end of 2024 or early 2025. The project will take about 4 years to complete.
Thank you, Scott, for providing some additional details about the Harrisonburg Widening Project. And I think based on that information, it's clear to see that this project is specifically established to enhance the safety of the interstate system, reduce congestion through the Harrisonburg area, and provide enhanced opportunity for economic development. And with that, I would like to thank all of you for joining us for another episode of the Improve 81 video series.